I'm ready to see some falls.
Some falls? Okay, you ready? Just ready? To pee paradise and put up a parking lot. And out here, in the wildness of the rainforest of St. Vincent, we have the green gecko. What happened? Did you did you reach for the ladder and just fall in?
Hi guys, I'm Isabel and this is Kieran, and this is our home, Merewether. Our adventures takes us from difficult conditions to the most secluded paradise islands.
Berks with bikinis.
We take our home around the world and we film everything that we do.
Oh, baby!
Subscribe to keep up with our dream. Thank you. Welcome back to Sailing Merewether. In last week's episode, we discovered the unknown island of St. Vincent. We walked up its volcano to the highest point of the island.
Last night we actually broke a rope, so my hair is wet because I've had a swim this morning trying to put our backup rope on the mooring again.
Yeah.
That's why I'm wet.
Everyone was wondering that.
Yeah.
No. But it's all good. Do you want to tell them what you did to the ropes? Because there is a bit of a swell here. I don't sleep that great when it's a big roll coming through.
I found an underwater mooring when we were putting an anchor down.
Yeah.
And yeah, we had a terrible night's sleep the first night, didn't we? So if I put a second rope to the stern, then I can actually move the boat, position it into the waves. So I saw the waves coming out side to side, they're coming forward and backwards, which is a lot more comfortable.
So much better. That's a little tip for you guys. We learned that little trick from Krishna, our friends. And I think we're a little bit late, might as well go and go catch our bus.
Wallet,
phone, sunscreen,
towel,
all on board.
Yep, good to go.
Renting a car for the second day with our fellow cruisers sailing vessel Wave, we made our way to the north of the island to see a popular waterfall and a national park.
So we've just here stopped at Cumberland Bay. We anchored here like 2 months ago, but we never actually got off the boat because we were just here for one day. But check this place out. I mean, at a height, it's stunning. There's just no wind in here. Where are we? What are we doing today?
I'm ready to see some falls.
Some falls? Okay, you ready? Just ready?
No.
You want to...
No. Waterfall.
What?
Oh, the shadow jacket.
Yeah. Is your window. This is when we go. When we leave the boat, she does the same thing.
Oh, really?
Just the things I have to deal with. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
To pee paradise and put up a parking lot. Doot, doot, doot. No?
No.
Don't know that song?
No.
You know that song? And don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you got till it's gone. To pee paradise, put up a
parking lot.
And now they pee paradise to put up a parking lot.
How good?
How good? Blake, what do you think?
It's amazing.
Yeah?
You see every time we take a turn. Being in the valley of La Soufriere, the volcano we climbed a day earlier, the landscape was teeming with life and having plenty of volcanic soil and water to aid the lush, green haven. We are just discovering paradise. Absolute green paradise out here. Somebody needs to tell God to turn the water back on, because the waterfall needs to be a little bit more, just a tiny bit more. I just want to go for a swim, oh, you know?
But it's so beautiful.
It's unreal. It's unreal. Having found a path, we climbed up to the second waterfall that met our needs for getting our hair wet.
Stop saying that?
No.
Probably.
Yeah, you're becoming more Australian every time you say it. Just give me one more time. One more time.
How about it?
Hey. They might even let you into the country sooner or later. Isabel got rejected because of the coronavirus. Sucks to be Swedish.
You
tell them I like Vegemite. She does like Vegemite. I didn't put it in the comments. I said you had an Australian boyfriend, but apparently I don't have as much power as I thought I did. Nobody cares about that. And out here, in the wildness of the rainforest of St. Vincent, we have the green gecko. He gets his name from
his greenness.
His greenness.
Here we found him on the spiky plant.
He lounges around on the spiky plant looking for the beautiful female which he will mate with. What do you think of the green gecko? So we are at.
We're in a movie.
We're in a movie. Of course, we're in a movie. What's this camera here for? We are at Port Royal,
Yeah. Which
is the main scene out of Pirates of the Caribbean number one.
Mm-hmm.
We anchored out here the first time we got into SVG, didn't we?
Yeah.
But we got out of here pretty quick, so it's pretty good to be back.
Mm.
We anchored out here.
This building was actually in the movie, and I think part of this dock as well.
Stopping at the most well-known petroglyph site in St Vincent, we discovered some of the ancient history of our temporary home. We also learnt the difference between a petroglyph and a hieroglyph. Okay, so a petroglyph is different from a hieroglyph because a petroglyph is actually scratched onto the rock and it takes many weeks to do it. So these petroglyphs and many others found around the island are over 1,000 years old. They were made in 300 AD, right? I think she said 300 AD. So yeah, there are some very, very old carvings in rocks.
Kingstown is the capital of St. Vincent. It is known for its botanical gardens, tropical plants, and its aviaries. It has a population of 16,500 people. And it is the center for agricultural industry and port of entry for cruisers and cruiser ships.
What are you doing there? What are you doing? What happened? Did you reach for the ladder and just fall in? Is that what happened?
I've had two big days on St. Vincent and decided to take a little swim.
I love going swimming in my normal clothes, which I just came back from a big day in. It's an awesome idea. You gotta bring me back to the boat now. Ladies and gentlemen, this is why she has no phone. How can you expect to keep a phone if you want to go for a swim all the time and use clothes?
I don't know. Oh. Well, my feet are not dirty anymore, so that's a plus.
Hey, win. The sunset's a bit of a win.
Another day, another adventure.
Yes, this is the third day in a row here in St. Vincent, and we have been invited on one of the most nicest men in the world. He's going to take us on his powerboat, and we're going to see the island from the ocean, aren't we?
Yeah. So apparently on land it will take 45 minutes, 50 minutes?
An hour and a half.
Oh, really?
An hour and a half. It's going to take us
on the boat, 20.
20 minutes on the boat, on these three big outboards just here.
Meeting one of the local businessmen on the island, we were given a hell of a fast ride around the leeward side of the island.
This is the leper bar, the actual bar. See the stairs coming down?
Yeah.
That's where so the lepers used to come down and wash all the bits off.
Wow.
Thank you. we were taken to a very remote bay where there were no roads and only a few farms. According to the locals, we have now arrived at one of the biggest and by far the best waterfall on the entire island. And we were thoroughly enjoying it. No rubbish or people to be seen. We were very thankful and appreciative to our new friend that has taken us on this beautiful journey. After an incredible day discovering what is very much an unknown island for most sailors and the Westerners alike, the island put on one last show with a pod of dolphins jumping and flipping at sunset. Catch us next week as our COVID lockdown continues in Tobago Cays. We sail from Bekwe to celebrate a friend's birthday with the good old barbecue on the beach.
So I'm trying to keep up with the boat. I'm a quick swimmer, so maybe we'll swim to
not that quick.
You know, we'll see each other in a couple of weeks when you come back to Bekwe and start
off. Right? No, I think I won't come back. And we're at a beam and we are flying. We went from going about 3.5-4 knots down wind and now we're up to 6 knots going across.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and become a part of our crew on the link below. Cheers.